Glory and honor be to the Almighty God. The Lord has been good to us. He has been good. The fact that He has prepared for us in heaven crowns, and whereby we will be able to settle down in His glory. Hence, He told us yesterday that we must be heavenly conscious and be spiritually minded in everything that we do. So my brother, my sister, let us just carry on doing that that pleases Him. You should be heavenly conscious at work, at home, even in our business. Because so many people today, because of the business transactions, they will put aside Christianity. Because there's a lot of dubious things going on in the business world. Pray that the Almighty God will strengthen you in faith and you'll be able to stand for Him in whatever situation in the name of Jesus. Today is Saturday, the 18th day of March. And the topic for today says, guard your faith. Guard your faith. Bow our heads to pray. O Lord, my God, how excellent is your name in all the earth. How excellent is your name, O Lord, my God, how excellent is your name in all the earth. How excellent is your name. You are the Alpha, you are the Omega, the beginning and the end, the helper of the helpless. How wonderful is your name, O Lord, my God. How excellent is your name in all the earth. How excellent is your name. Mighty Father, you are wonderful. Gracious Redeemer, you are the good God. An excellent Father. Father, your names are wonderful. They do marvelous things. We thank you because you have never spared us. You are always getting us to have an understanding of how to make it at the end. And how that the pathway we should take so that it will be well with us. So my Lord and my Father, under this teaching of today, guard us again in the name of Jesus. Whatsoever might be causing a dwindling in our faith, Father, we pray that you will deal with them today in the name of Jesus. Father, you will build us so strong in our faith in you in the name of Jesus. We trust you, eternal Father, for your intervention into every situation that might be in the life of your children that are listening today. Father, you will arise on behalf of everybody and let there be testimonies in the name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father. We appreciate you. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. Welcome to the presence of the Almighty God. Guard your faith. The memory verse is taken from Jude chapter 1 and verse 20. Jude 1 verse 20 says, but ye, beloved, building up yourself in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. This is an admonition for us to have an in-depth into part of the things that the Holy Spirit has come to do. Yesterday, we were told that He is the Comforter, that He has come to comfort us in every situation. But here today, we're being told of how it can impact our prayer life. Because without any doubt, it's not how you can pray in the physical and be able to meet up as expected of the Almighty God. Because Romans chapter 8 verse 26, Romans 8 verse 26 says, likewise the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. When the Holy Spirit takes over to pray through you, you'll be praying correctly because He is God. He knows what is in the mind of God. He knows what is your future. And that is why praying in the Holy Ghost becomes crucial to children of God. And if you are not yet baptized in the Holy Spirit, I'll plead with you today. By the time you'll be rounding up, the touch of God will come upon your life and you'll be able to flow in the Holy Spirit. Because Paul, that was writing here, made it clear to us in one of his passages that I can speak in tongues more than ye all. He was writing, said, even though people are speaking in tongues, and no wonder you could see the hand of God powerful upon his life. The Bible passage for today is in 1 John chapter 5, verses 4 and 5. 1 John chapter 5, verses 4 and 5. Says, for whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Who is he that overcometh the world, but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God? He that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God. Statement here is about overcoming the world. And the position of our faith in living this victorious life is very crucial to overcome the world. To overcome the world, the position of our faith in the Lord is very important. Whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. Because we know that without faith, it is impossible to please the Lord. Hebrews 11:6 makes it clear. Without faith, it's impossible to please the Lord. And anybody that wants God to answer him and act at the time of prayers must believe in him. And in Romans chapter 1, verse 17, Romans 1:17, it says, for therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. For it is written, the just shall live by faith. Anybody that wants to be just before the Almighty God must be such that live by faith, believing that Jesus is the Son of God. He has come to this planet Earth. He says, who is it that overcometh the world? He that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God. Believing that Jesus is the Son of God makes you an overcomer. Hence, the statement that we have just heard, that who is he that overcometh the world? Hence, today, there are a lot of things that are happening in our generation. A lot of things. He is the Son of God. But many are arguing this. There's a lot of contention over this issue. People don't have contention on the fact that there is God. But when it comes to the aspect of Jesus Christ, you start to see a lot of theories. A lot of things that people say. But we want to establish it again for you to be able to take your stand in any situation. In Matthew chapter 3, verses 16 and 17, says, and Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straight way out of the water. And lo, the heavens were opened unto him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lightning upon him. And lo, a voice from heaven saying, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. That was a voice that came from heaven. It wasn't a human voice. at his baptism, God in heaven declared that he is his beloved son. So if anybody is just trying to convince you of something, say, but God cannot lie. God spoke himself. A voice from heaven came. Voice from heaven came. And also in Matthew chapter 17, Matthew 17 verses from verse 3 to 5, verse 3 to 5, at the time of the transfiguration, and behold, there appeared unto them Moses and Elias, talking with him. Then answered Peter and said unto Jesus, Lord, it is good for us to be here. If thou wilt, let us make here three tabernacles, one for thee, and for one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he yet spake, behold, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and behold, a voice out of the cloud, which said, this is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear ye him. At another time, at the baptism, at the transfiguration, if I say the same thing, say the same thing, God's beloved son. God's beloved son. Many profess to be doing the will of God, yet not believing that Jesus is the Son of God. Not believing. And yet, say we're doing the work of God. Then it means that something is wrong somewhere. Something is wrong. Look at John chapter 6, 28 and 29. John 6, 28 and 29. Then said they unto him, what shall we do that we might work the works of God? Jesus answered and said unto them, this is the work of God, that ye believe on him whom he hath sent. You say you are doing the work of God and you have not believed on Jesus Christ. Jesus has declared himself that this is the work of God. We believe on the one that has been sent. Jesus is the one that was sent. If you have not believed in him, you are not doing the work of God. If your lifestyle does not go the way he has predicted and put down, you are not doing the work of God. You are doing contrary to the later principles of the one that has been sent. You are not doing the work of God. He said it himself. And is the judge that we are going to face on the last days. Because, say, we're doing the work of God, and you have not accepted Jesus as the Son of God. On the last days, we will be facing him. We will be facing him. And is the one to declare that you have not been doing the work that he has given unto us. Because you have not believed in him. So in 2 Corinthians 5 verse 10, 2 Corinthians 5 verse 10, it says, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body, according to that he has done, whether it be good or bad. The one we have not accepted as the Son of God is going to be the judge. And when you appear before him, how do you present yourself? So there'll be no room, no way for escape on the last days. And that is why we must take our stand now for him. That verse in 1 John 5:5 says, who is he that hath overcometh the world, but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God? For us to be able to be an overcomer of the rudiments of this world, of the sins and the carnality of this world, our faith in the Lord Jesus must be strong. Must be strong. So as you go through life, the winds, waves, and storms of life will work against your progress. But be encouraged by the testimony of those who have successfully gone ahead of you in the Christian race. There are so many of them. People like Paul, people like Peter, have gone ahead of us. And when you look at Hebrews chapter 11, that are called the catalog of the heroes of faith, they went through storms and challenges of life, and yet they overcame. in such a way too, as we study their lifestyle, we will also overcome. They serve as witnesses of God's ability to keep the called, to keep his children from falling. Yes, to keep his children from falling. Hebrews 12, verse 1. Wherefore, seeing ye also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight, and the sin which doth so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. This is chapter 12 that is encouraging us as per what had been written in chapter 11, talking about the heroes of faith. It says, we have compassing are about us now great cloud of witnesses. Therefore, be encouraged, my brother. Be encouraged, my sister. There is nothing you are passing through that people in this particular chapter have not faced. There have been people like Daniel, people like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Is it Abraham, our father of faith? Is mention them. Is it Deborah? Is it Barak and all the rest of people? At their own time, they faced serious issues. Joseph, Moses, and all the rest. And yet, God helped them. The God that helped them, we help you in the name of Jesus. So God not only calls, he also keeps and sustains the called. He sustains the called. Jude chapter 1 and verse 24 says, now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. Our God is a divine keeper. Is a divine keeper. Is able to keep us through every situation. Genesis 28 verse 15 says, verse 15 of Genesis 28, and behold, I am with thee, and we keep thee in all places whither thou goest, and we bring thee again into this land. For I will not leave thee until I have done that which I have spoken to thee of. It's a divine keeper. It's a divine keeper. It's a companion in the journey of life. It's a companion. He said, I will never leave thee. I will never forsake thee. And in Psalm 121, verse 4, Psalm 121, verse 4, being a divine keeper, he gives us, this verse gives us an assurance, because it is someone who does this that can easily keep watch over you. Verse 4 says, behold, he that keepeth Israel never slumber nor sleep. Is a sleepless watchman. The one that is watching over you never sleeps. You might have your security guards all around you. They are human beings. They might sleep off. And apart from this, all the guards, physical guards around you, they cannot watch over you spiritually. When evil spirits are trying to manipulate things around you, they don't see it. But we have a God that is a divine keeper. Divine keeper. He is able to keep one faultless. Because in Daniel chapter 6 and verse 4, it was a declaration by the people on Daniel. It says, then the presidents and the princes sought to find occasions against Daniel concerning the kingdom, but they could find none occasion nor fault. For as much as he was faithful, neither was there any error or fault found in him. He's able to keep you faultless. So brethren, be assured that God can keep you from falling. He can also keep you from failing. He can preserve you on your trip to destiny. Can preserve you on your trip. As you journey, he has the ability to keep you from falling, to keep you from failing, and to make it to destiny. 1 Samuel chapter 29, verse 3. 1 Samuel 29, verse 3. It says, then said the princes of the Philistines, what do these Hebrews do here? And Achish said unto the princes of the Philistines, is not this David, the servant of Saul, the king of Israel, which had been with me these days or these years, and have found no fault in him, since he fell unto me unto this day? Since he has been there, he was just doing the will of God, marching to destiny. He can keep you safe and living right before him. Have you been unstable in your Christian life? I've seen Satan and the world been buffeting you so much that you are not experiencing the reality of a triumphant Christian life. Is that your experience? I want you to look back today, call back unto God. Come back unto him and say, Lord, I've missed my steps. He is able to keep you. He kept the people of old. The one who is able to keep you faultless will begin to strengthen you from today in Jesus' name. By his grace, you will no longer be a victim of sin. The yoke of an inconsistent walk with God is broken in your life today in the name of Jesus. Receive the grace to live faultless before God's throne in Jesus' name. 1 John 5:4 says, for whosoever is born of God overcometh the world, and this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Even our faith. If you are truly born again, you have been placed in a position that is in opposition to sin. Born again, opposition is an opposition to sin, Satan, and the world. You should not in any way be found messing up with the things of the world. It is a wrong teaching of today to be saying it does not matter. When you fall into sin and they tell you it does not matter, when you go into worldliness and they tell you it does not matter, is a way of keeping you in that particular opposite side. And God will not be happy with you in that position. These entities will come against you on a daily basis. That is sin, Satan, and the world. They will come on a daily basis. However, you should not be afraid, because God has given you the faith that overcomes. Faith that overcomes. It is your duty to feed this faith and make it grow. This is why we have to know that there are categories of faith. Matthew 6:30 talks about little faith. When Jesus was talking, he said, you of little faith. Faith can be little. It's a category of faith. Matthew 6, verse 30. Wherefore, if God so clothes the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? That's one aspect of faith. And in Luke 17, verse 6, he also spoke about faith like a mustard seed. Faith like a mustard seed. But in Luke 7, verse 9, Jesus said, when Jesus heard these things, he marveled at him, and turned him about, and said unto the people that followed him, I say unto you, I have not found so great faith. No, not in Israel. Here we're talking about great faith. Great faith. So faith can grow when you feed the faith. Well, now do you feed the faith? Feed the faith with the word of God. Feed the faith. Feed the faith. Faith is like your body that requires food daily. The right food will strengthen and increase it. The right food will strengthen and increase it, enabling it to withstand opposing forces, while the wrong diet will cause it to grow weak. Romans chapter 10, verse 17. So it should feed our faith so that the faith will grow. Romans 10, 17. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Feed your faith with the word of God. Live by the word. Believe the word. And make sure that continue to live the word. Your faith will grow. Don't kill your faith, my brother. Don't kill your faith, my sister. Separate yourself from all those who constantly tell you that you cannot make it. Anyone giving negative statements contrary to the word of God, never befriend them. Anyone that will always tell you that it can never happen, this can never be done, always talking about impossibilities, don't associate with them, because God's, the word of God says, with God, nothing shall be impossible. In that situation, you find yourself. Encourage yourself, coming with people who will be speaking the word of faith to you. That keep on, God will do it. Keep on, the heavens will be open unto you very soon. And before you know it, this world will bear fruit. In you, in Jesus' name, separate yourself from all those who constantly tell you that you cannot make it. Put a distance between you and anyone that wants to lure you into sin. Because sin will make you an enemy of God. Also, watch your activities on the internet and social media. Because so that you will do not destroy your faith. On the social media today, there are a lot of pollutants and contaminants. Be careful. Be careful on the sites you watch. Feed and develop your faith daily by studying the Bible, listening to messages of true servant of God. Look at that statement. True servant of God. All those that have, you can see the practical life in them. All those you can see the lifestyle of Jesus in them. Those are the ones you should listen to, not just anybody. Listen to testimonies, seeking counsel from godly counselors, and by praying in the Holy Spirit. If there is one thing you need to jealously guard against, guard always, is your faith. So, the memory verse says, but ye, beloved, building up yourself in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. So, we mentioned here, we need to pray in the Holy Ghost. The key point of today says, with faith, you can win all the battles of life and make heaven. Don't give up the fight of faith. Now bow down your heads as we pray. Say, Father, help me to increase my faith. Help me increase my faith, O God. Help me increase my faith. Eternal Father, help me increase my faith. Mighty Redeemer, help me increase my faith. Eternal Redeemer, help me increase my faith. And therefore, my Father, my God, help me study the word. Help me, my Father, my God, help me study the word. Help me listen to messages that will build up my faith from now on. In the name of Jesus, help me, O God. Help me, O God. And now, because you are a child of God, you will believe In the Lord Jesus Christ, it says, praying in the Holy Ghost will help you build up your faith. Now, join me as we pray in the Holy Spirit for a minute or two. Talk and start to talk to the Holy, to God in the Holy Spirit. Maporia magashta kuria bagatinta imbrologobosikiba mashandalaba ndrelegobosakuria mahatra zefri makatiske pukuria mabrabro zenkashta kuria lagayasata leke malata sontorogose sankaligata prigo sokuria bagayasrokoske fiske prelegomba mashanda kuria makatasustre zekri legabasanta kushte kiria lagayafa piko sokuria makali galataya jekende kebo bakaria de gezotire senkalibahata. Thank you, Tana Father. Lay your hands on that particular set. Lay your hands on that particular set, because the anointing of God is going to connect with you there. Makoro mozonkoria, makpashikria, ngrelegegeske, puria ma prabla bagaya sataya, mashanda kuru mozontoria, because sekiri bakusekiba. Father Lord, in the name of Jesus, I pray, Father, as your children, my Father, my, are connecting with faith, Lord God Almighty, because there's no distance in the spiritual, my Lord and my Father. I pray, Lord, that your anointing will rest upon you and your children in the name of Jesus. Father, you help everyone build up our faith, either by studying the word, by listening to genuine messages, my Father, my God, and in the prayer of the Holy Spirit, Lord, as your children have laid their hands on their sets, Father, contact them, oh God. But the Bible says, out of their belly shall flow the rivers of living water. I pray that the Holy Spirit will burst out in everyone in the name of Jesus. Glory be to your name, oh God. We appreciate you. In Jesus' name we are praying. Join us as we sing, My Faith Looks Up to Thee. God bless you.
then sing out, then it